Hello everyone, welcome to the Machine Shop Lab. I'm Uday, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, HABIT, Bangalore. Today I'm here to explain you about a milling machine. So the milling machine what we have over here is a horizontal milling machine. To say it in specific, it is called as column and knee type milling machine. Okay, so coming to the parts of the milling machine, it starts with a base, okay, and a column at the back and overarm at the top. Okay, these are the major parts, but column is the one which carries the major driving units and the speed controlling unit. So overarm is being carried by with the yoke, to which is being connected with the arbor. So this arbor is being connected to the spindle rod with the help of a spacers. Okay, if you can see over here, you can see a gear that is being placed, which we call it as a gear cutter. So this is what is a gear cutter. On this you can see a numbering given as 1.50, which shows that the model of the cutter. And this is the blank that we will be going to cut, and this is an example for which you are going to see the number of teeth that is being cut by using a milling machine. So coming to the mechanism over here, if you see, this is the knee which is used for the height adjustment, and this is for the work table adjustment. Onto the work table we have a slot T slot arrangements, to which we have placed the indexing mechanism. So coming to the main part of this is the indexing mechanism, which you need to take the care of. So coming to the parts of this, we have a plunger, this is a crank that has been fixed to this, this is an indexing plate, this is a sector arm, and this is an indexing mechanism which we have inside this. So inside this we have two gear arrangement. One is a shaft which has a single started thread engaged with a worm gear. So worm gear has a 40 teeth, which we keep it as a standard. That is in turn is being connected to the workpiece folder, as you can see over here. Okay, to start up with this machine, so the initial adjustment what we need to do, or the calculation that has to be carried out, is a method called a simple indexing method. With respect to this, we have other indexing method like compound indexing, angular indexing, etc. But with respect to the syllabus that is being procured by the VTU, we have a simple indexing method, and the formula that we use is 40 by n. So 40 by n, where 40 stands for the number of worm gear teeth, so which is placed inside this, which is a standard one which does not change, and n is the number of divisions to be cut on the blank which we need to do the cutting operations. So here, so module of the cutter will be given to you, because the cutter what profile it is, that will be given to you. And here what we used is the cutter having a modulus number as 2, and the blank of the workpiece that has been given over here is 104. So to start with the calculation, we need to find the value of n. So to use it, we have the formula d is equal to m into n plus 2, where d is the diameter of the blank and m is the module of the cutter. By using the formula, we'll get the value of n. So with respect to the module cutter 2 and the diameter 104, we are getting the value as 50. So when you substitute to the main equation, that is 40 by n, we have 40 divided by 50. When simplified, we get it as 4 by 5. To this we have a multiple factor taken as 7 by 5. The main reason for this is to check out the indexing plate number. So if you see this fraction what you have got in the numerator, that value 28 stands for the number of holes that has to be moved on the indexing plate, and 35 is the hole number that has to be selected onto the indexing plate. So indexing plate over here, it consists of various number of circular holes, okay, each having its own numbers. If I show it over here, we have 13, 17, 20, 23 and 35. So with respect to the fraction, what we got is the number 35 at the denominator, which shows that the whole number that we need to select is 35. So your plunger is been fixed over here, okay, and to this we have a sector arm that will be placed over here. So the sector arm function is to restrict the initial position of the hole, and the numerator value 28 indicates that the number of holes that has to be moved onto the indexing plate. So if you see over here, so you have different number of holes. When we count over here, it stops 28. So once when I try to move this, okay, you can make an observation over here, which gives an indication that even your blank of the workpiece is being moved, right? So when it has been moved, this angular shift is being given with respect to the mechanism that is being provided inside. So once it has been done, you are giving an initial start to this. So when you start it, you need to move your workpiece against the cutter rotation. So here we are using a cast iron as a material, so the running speed is being reduced, okay, so that it is much more harder than the cutter. And the process that has to be carried out is at a slower rate. If you move the workpiece at a faster speed, so there is a chances that the cutter teeth may get damaged. So you can check out the teeth profile is being generated. Once it is being completely cut, you need to retrace the same path before going for the further indexing mechanism. Right, in the same fashion, you need to move back it. So once it is being done, you can stop the machine or you can keep it running. Okay. So since we had moved in that 35 holes, we have moved to 28th hole number. So you need to move this sector arm back to this position so that this locks to the initial position for the next operation. And this further will be moved back. And when you're rotating it, make sure that you have moved it at a slower rate. In case if you have moved it further and reversed it back, the alignment goes off and your teeth profile may not match with the next teeth what you are going to make it. So the repetition happens in the same way which you have done for the first cut. So if you can check out, there is a space that has been provided, that is an angular profile that has been given to it. So the teeth profile changes. Once the slot is been completely done, again move back the workpiece to its initial position. And this cycle repeats. Again, move the sector arm. So this locks the initial position for the next operation. And then again rotate it to the next hole number and lock it. And the cycle repeats until the circumference of the given blank is being cut to equal number of divisions. So once it has been done, what you can observe is the number of teeth on the profile that has been given. So if you count also, so with respect to the calculation what you have obtained, so you'll get the same value, that is 50 number of teeth. With respect to the blank that is being given of 104 and the cutter is 2 with a module 2. I hope you have understood the working mechanism of a gear cutting that is being carried out by using a horizontal milling machine. So the viva questions which are very important for you during your vivas are, few questions related to that will be asked, will be normal. So what is the importance of a modulus of a cutter? Second one, okay, list me the different types of milling machines apart from this horizontal milling machine and types of indexing methods which I have already stated. Okay, apart from that, why is the spaces required? How many types of cutters can be used using a horizontal milling machine and so on. With respect to the operations you have carried out, there will be different operations which you will be carrying out on a milling machine. So you'll be having a questions related to different operations that can be carried out using a milling machines. So these are the few important questions that generally been asked with respect to the milling operations or milling machines that comes to you in your viva. Thank you.